Hey guys, welcome to the final episode of Project Runway Season 7. Yes, it's Bryant Park Week. This is it, kids. This is what we've been waiting for all season. So, last week we found out that Mila, Seth, and Emilio are the final three. So it's one day before the show and Tim arrives. And yeah, Seth Aaron has 24 looks. What? I can't believe he actually had 24 looks. Not 24 pieces, 24 looks. Emilio, he's a sneaky snake. He doesn't trust Tim. That's not cool because Tim's only there to help you. He's not trying to sabotage you. And Mila, she roughed up the styling a little bit. So, yeah, she's in good hands there. So, it's time for the model casting, and Mila wants some edgier rockers. Emilio wants his models to represent the world, so he just wants anyone, I suppose. And Seth Aaron wants the total package. He wants a strong walker. All right, makeup with Collier Strong, and then fittings. I felt like this whole show was being totally rushed. I mean, 10 minutes into the show, and already we're like, oh, it's 30 minutes before the Bryant Park show. They really rushed through this part where they should be showing lots of drama and everything, which I really look forward to, and I was a little nonplussed. So they showed the tent, and yes, it's amazing, it's huge, it's cavernous, and now it's 30 minutes before the show, and Mila is missing three models. Emilio's missing one, and he was behaving like a little bitch. Mila, at least, was like, oh, I don't know who to talk to. What do I do? And Amelia was like, I want that bitch replaced now. What? I can't stand Emilio. I'm sorry. I didn't like him all season. I didn't like his attitude. I didn't like his bitchiness towards the other contestants. So the judges arrive. Michael Kors, Nina Garcia, and guest judge Faith Hill. You might say, she's a country music singer. What does she know about fashion? I have no idea. But apparently she must know something if they chose her. So Seth Aaron, his line. What was up with his hair? It looked like he had on a hunting cap with the flaps on the side. Apparently his line was inspired by German-Russian military of the 1940s. Okay, because they all look like they could walk the runway. So it was basically black and white and red, a little houndstooth, a splash of purple here and there, and some really ugly yellow plaid, which I didn't like except on those legging pants. The judges thought his line was more sophisticated. He had lots of ideas. That, to me, sounds like his line was not cohesive. Nobody really liked the purple short dress, but then at the end they were like, oh, they would love that purple short dress. It was borderline costumey, and I'm going to have to agree with that, because some of the pieces seemed really a little bit off the wall. All right, Mila's line. She was inspired by shadows. She had also had a lot of black, white, and gray, and houndstooth. Lots of coats, lots of stripes, and one little shiny dress at the end, which I didn't get. But I really liked that dress, but I didn't see how it related to the rest of the line. It was contemporary. It was fresh. She took the 60s that she loved and she made it for now. Her color blocking was updated. You know, she was a big fan of doing that all the time, her geometry. And she took their advice on hair and makeup. When you take the judges' advice, you make them happy. So it was boring, though. Supposedly. There was no surprises. I thought it was pretty surprising because it wasn't what I was used to seeing from her, so I liked it. Emilio, his line was called Color Me Bad. His mom and his sisters inspired it. I don't see how it related to the title Color Me Bad, but there was a lot of color. Lots of wearable color. His line was very commercial. Plus one crazy gown at the end, which I didn't get at all. I mean, I loved it, but I didn't see how it related to the line. Everybody loved his printed fabric, except for me. And Michael really liked the gown. I think everybody pretty much liked the gown. But again, how did it go? He had a lot of coats. He needs more feminine. There was a lot of coats. A lot of separates. Their main argument with him was that he was showing a line, not a collection. There was no drama. And how many people noticed how much eye rolling was going on when the judges were explaining what they thought of people's collections? They were all like, "Oh, Seth Aaron. Oh, Mila. Bleh." All of the final contestants, it seemed like nobody could stand each other at all. So, yeah, it's a really tough decision, as usual. But Mila, sorry, you're out, which means Seth Aaron, you win Project Runway. So they did things a little bit different this year. They went right to the Project Runway reunion, which was only a half an hour, and I'm so used to it being an hour all the time. Actually, I don't even know if they had one last season. But Tim and Nina were the host and hostess. All of the designers and models were there, I guess, because this is the first year that they've had models of the runway. And Emilio, right off the bat, he seemed pretty bitter with the whole situation. He was like, "Everybody said they love mine, but why did it not win then?" Because it was a line, not a collection. You would have won if it was the most wearable, I suppose. But that's not what it was. So Anthony got recognized at the toll booth. Go, Anthony. And Ping forgot she was on the show. And actually, when I saw Ping in the beginning, I was like, "Oh, that was this season. It seemed like 100 years ago." So, model loyalty, not if you're Emilio. Holly, the model, wore that stupid bikini that he made on the hardware challenge, which was really uncomfortable for her to do. Yet he dumped her. Go figure. It's a competition, kids. According to him, I don't know. I think I would have had a little more loyalty than that. So the favorite challenge seemed to be the hardware challenge. Probably not for Emilio though. So private smack talking going on behind the scenes, you betcha. I mean, that's what reality TV is all about. When you're in that little confessional, it's time to let loose, especially if you had a brewski or two-ski. So Mila apologizes to Antony, and Antony apologizes to Mila. There was some other minor apologies going on, but you know what? Tim doesn't talk smack, and anybody who says he does, you just better shut up. So Jay, he got his nose bent out of shape, and he went on a little personal attack on Kerry. He said that's why he doesn't hire models that have bad teeth and thick legs. I could think of a four-letter word for you, Jay, and it's jerk. That was so uncalled for. You could have heard a pin drop after he let that bomb loose. So, yeah, Ping might be a wreck, but Jessie's a jerk as well. You know what? Ping's very sensitive, and she has important ideas just as much as everybody else. Just because she doesn't have the sewing experience that you do, it's no reason to attack her. So, why did Maya really leave the show? Because of the reason she told you, kids. She wasn't trying to hide anything. She just graduated design school and she just felt like she wasn't ready. She's got to grow up. It's too soon. Too much pressure. All right, so it just so happens that Valeria, the model, who was hooked up with Seth Aaron, had to leave as well, which is really sucky because she had to pay her bills. And if she had stayed, Seth Aaron probably would have kept her and she would have been the winning model. Life sucks when you got to make big decisions. So I also applaud Nina for Jonathan had said that he really respects Nina for not being afraid to have her own opinion, even if it's different from the Coors and the Heidi. Yeah, I'm gonna have to agree because I can really respect that in Nina, and I know a lot of times she really stuck her neck out there. When she was not agreeing with everyone, didn't make much of a difference though, because it seemed like they overruled her most of the time. So let's just get this straight for the record. Tim is amazing, period. Don't talk smack about Tim. And thanks for watching, kids. It was an interesting season. I definitely have to agree with the judges. This was one of the most talented groups of Project Runway, and I hope you enjoyed it, because I sure did. Till next time, much love.